Hi, my name's Steve. Welcome aboard my narrowboat home, Moreland Rose. Please join me as I take a slow boat through Britain. I finished last time at Castlefield Basin, in the heart of Manchester, with a new canal, the Bridgewater. First things first, I'm facing a dead end, so I need to turn around, or wind. Although no longer usable, beyond that lift bridge ahead is a 220-yard long tunnel, built by James Brindley. The tunnel passes below his Rochdale Canal to an underground loading area, which serviced a huge warehouse. Goods were then lifted to street level by a hoist. Through those arches ahead is the source of water for the Bridgewater Canal, the River Medlock. It's not navigable, so I need to turn around here. In its day, this area was a bustling hub of warehouses, many now converted to apartments or offices. It's great to see them repurposed rather than just demolished. The five-storey building behind me is Middle Warehouse, now converted into 2 and 3 bedroom apartments, currently on the market at around £500,000 each. Behind me is Merchant's Warehouse, now converted into offices. It is the oldest surviving warehouse in the basin, built around 1827. As well as unloading on the main canal beneath those wooden hoods, or catheads as they were known, boats could also be taken through the two arches to be unloaded in the dry. There is the entrance to the Rochdale Canal through Duke's Lock, which we came through in the last video. Manchester's extensive tram system makes use of the original rail bridges in the city centre, although, as we shall see, new lines have been built further out. The whole area is a warren of small loading arms and bays, showing how important the canal was to trade in the city at one time. The canal was built in 1763 for Francis Egerton, the Duke of Bridgewater, to get coal from his mines in Worsley into the city of Manchester. As such, it is claimed by many to be the first true canal in the country. Although it is predated by other waterways, they involved making rivers artificially navigable.
On YouTube!
starboard is the remains of Holme locks. Until 1995, two locks here dropped the canal down onto the River Irwell and the Manchester Ship Canal. Slowly, as we leave Manchester Centre, the warehouses die out, but a lot of redevelopment is still being carried out on the surrounding land. But the noise of industry is still heard from behind the high walls that border the towpath. Even this close to the city, the canal still provides a green corridor for wildlife. This is Pomona Lock, the only remaining usable lock which links the River Irwell and the Manchester Ship Canal to the Bridgewater. It's not often I get to overtake a train with Moreland Rose. New bridges and stations were built to accommodate Metrolink, the Manchester tram system. This section was opened in March 2020, making it the UK's largest light rail system with 99 stops and 65 miles of track. Castle is an old-fashioned term for a song thrush, a native British songbird. I like the fact that this modern wall has been built with a nod to the arched wharf buildings of an earlier era. Shame about the huge screen on the other side though. Probably one of the most famous football grounds in the world, Old Trafford, home to Manchester United. The area still retains its links to transport, with thousands of shipping containers being stacked in the yard to starboard. I will be taking the right-hand arm here, but first I need to make a small diversion for diesel and Caligan. There's a small boat yard a few hundred yards along the arm to port. Fuel supplies replenished, time to wind and head back to the lee arm. This was the original canal, linking direct to Manchester, with no junction here. That was added later. I couldn't leave Manchester without getting some more rain. Fortunately, it wasn't much. One of the reasons this canal survives in such good condition is the Kellogg's factory here. Maize from Canada was unloaded on the Manchester Ship Canal and brought through the Hulme and Pomona locks we saw earlier in specially built barges and transported to Kellogg's own wharf. Unfortunately, the larger modern ships couldn't use the ship canal, and the trade stopped in 1974. One of the wonders of the waterways, Barton Swing Aqueduct carries the Bridgewater Canal over the Manchester Ship Canal. It is the only swing aqueduct in the world, built in 1893 to replace the original stone aqueduct when the Manchester Ship Canal was built. The 235-foot long, 650-ton trough pivots about a centre point to allow ship traffic to pass along the larger waterway. Gates at either end of the trough hold in 800 tons of water as the caisson is rotated 90 degrees by a hydraulic engine. I would have loved to have seen it in action. Unfortunately, that's much less frequent nowadays. The Monton Lighthouse is a folly built by Phil Austin. Apparently, just because he could. Great one, Phil. At least these ducks don't come tapping on the side of the boat for food in the morning. No locks today, but there aren't any on the length of the Bridgewater Canal. I shall be mooring here at Worsley Dell, where it all began. The entrance to the Duke's Mines is by that timber frame building ahead. Amazing to think that 260 years ago, coal was loaded onto barges in the depths of those mines and transported along the route we have just come, into the centre of an expanding Manchester. I hope you've enjoyed the trip and look forward to taking you towards that other thriving port, Liverpool. See you next time.